What's up, beautiful people? Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Andy, aka The Dynamite Natural. I make natural hair and girl talk videos. So if you love this sort of content, if you love this sort of videos, don't forget to subscribe down below and turn on your post notifications to all so that you can be notified each and every single time I post a new video. So today I'm going to be telling you 10 feminine hygiene tips that your mom forgot to tell you. So the very first one is you smell like what you eat. Don't eat a lot of junk food, processed foods, alcohols, and even spicy foods like garlic. It's going to make the way you smell down there really off. But you want to eat more natural foods like fruits and vegetables. Fruits like pineapples and bananas are really good for making you smell right down there. And also drink a lot of water. Don't play with your water intake, ladies. If you're sexually active, make sure that you always pee or urinate after sex to prevent UTIs or urinary tract infections. The third tip is always wear cotton underwear. It's breathable. Pick cotton underwear. Pick cotton material over any kind of material. If you're going for underwears, panties, make sure you pick cotton material. It is breathable, okay, and it is better for the health of your vajay. The fourth tip is always stay dry down there. Never let yourself stay wet down there. After a bath or a swim, make sure that you dry yourself very well and make sure that you are dry down there, because wetness down there can cause yeast infections or smell. This also boils back to the cotton underwear. The cotton underwear is going to help you stay dry. If you use silk underwear, silk, like I say here on my channel when I talk about natural hair videos, you use silk to retain moisture. So silk underwear is going to retain moisture. And I've already told you what the moisture down there can cause. It can cause yeast infections. It can also cause smell. So you want to make sure that you stick with cotton material, because cotton material is going to help you stay dry. And my fifth feminine hygiene tip is stay dry by sleeping without panties at night to allow yourself stay dry and air out. Feminine hygiene tip number six, for sweaty boobs, you want to use talcum powder to prevent smell. That is what I use. It's the best thing ever. If you don't want to use powder, you can always use a deodorant, but it has to be aluminium free. Number seven feminine hygiene tip is when using pads or tampons, especially tampons, you don't want your tampons to stay in there for more than 3 to 4 hours, no matter how light your flow is, to prevent smell. Feminine hygiene tip number seven or number eight is if you use tampons of higher absorbency than you need, you will have toxic shock syndrome. I have a whole video where I talked more about toxic shock syndrome. I will leave this video right here. I will leave the link in the iCards and also in the description box. So go ahead and check it out, where I talked about how to smell good on your period. I explained in detail toxic shock syndrome. So you want to go ahead and check it out. Feminine hygiene tip number nine, using pads lets your period flow out instead of soaking onto the walls of your vajay with the tampon, and that causes metallic smell. Again, I explained this in detail in my how to smell good on your period video. I will leave that video in the link to the video in the description box down below and in the iCards. So go ahead and check it out. So if you use pads, using pads lets the period blood flow out so that it doesn't stay in there and develop metallic smell. So that is tip number nine. Tip number 10 is do not use soap in your vagina. When I say do not use soap in your vagina, I'm talking about do not use soap in there where you meet your cervix, in there, the path that leads to your uterus. Do not use soap there. On the external area where you have the clitoris, that is your vulva. You can use soap there if you want to. Like, it is actually advised to use a non-scented soap down there to prevent sensitivities and itching and stuff like that. But inside your vagina, the path that leads to your cervix and your uterus, do not take soap in there. It is actually self-cleansing. Using soaps inside your vagina is actually going to cause fishy smell, which is a common characteristic of BV, bacterial vaginosis. Again, I explained more about this in my How to Smell Good on Your Period video. I will leave the link again. The link is in the description box and is also in the iCard. So go ahead and check out that video. It is going to be very helpful. So yeah, those are my 10 feminine hygiene tips for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that this video was helpful. If you like this video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe down below, turn on your post notifications to all, and leave me comments down below. Let me also know some feminine hygiene tips that you use to take care of yourself. Your girl would love to know too. So yeah, that is what I have for you guys today. If you like it, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, share it with someone that you know it will be helpful for, or it will be helpful too. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate that. I will see you in the next video. Bye.